أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن
we will not be lost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look up after us. You left us here in this place, and Allah will take it. You leave us here, and He will take over. We are not left alone, for He is with us. And this Iman, this faith of Hajar alayhi salam, is a great faith that we need to bring in our hearts to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to ask Him for His support and to realize that He is with us all the time. As Allah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his young cousin, Abdullah ibn Abbas, كُنْ مَعَ اللَّهِ فِي الشِّدَّةِ كُنْ مَعَ اللَّهِ فِي الرَّخَاءِ يَكُنْ مَعَكَ فِي الشِّدَّةِ. Be with Allah when things are easy, and He will be with you when things are difficult. تعرف على الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. So this is something to keep in mind, the sacrifice that the young wife of Ibrahim عليه السلام made is a great sacrifice. But it displays also her faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, her submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the same manifests itself many years later with Ismail alayhi salam, when Ibrahim came to him and he told him that I see in my dreams that I am slaughtering you. And the dreams of the prophets salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi are true. And the young man said to his father, اِفْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ سَتَجِنُنِي إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. A young man accepted from his father that he would be slaughtered. This is a great sacrifice. Again, the reason behind accepting it is the submission, Islam, the submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we need to bring this into our hearts, the hearts of those around us, to have unshaken belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to submit to the will of Allah. When we have done our homework, when we have done what we need to do, the rest is left with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with this Iman, we will be able to do miracles. We will be able to do a lot of things. If we do not have this faith in our hearts and the reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our deeds, then we will be lost. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that if you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then through reliance, He will take care of you. But if you rely on other things, you will be left to these other means. So we need as Muslims not only to remember the sacrifices, but to remember what is behind these sacrifices, the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when our brothers and sisters who are performing their hajj, they do their sa'y, we remember the young woman, the young wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Hajar, who was looking for water for her young infant and was running between Safa and Marwa, searching for water, and she couldn't find it. And she prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help her and to help her son. And indeed she went back to her son to see the water coming under his feet. This is the miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Hajar and to the house of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And soon the prayers of Ibrahim, when he left his young family behind, became true. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his prayers. فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِ. Let the hearts of people from always longing to visit Mecca al-Mukarramah, visit the Haram. And this is the answer of the prayer that today we see Hajjis from everywhere responding to the prayers of Ibrahim alayhi salam when Allah told him, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ فِي الْحَجِّ, and called people to Hajj, and they shall come from every place. This is a sacrifice that we made today for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we make our dhabiha and qurban, but we need to go beyond this kind of sacrifice. Some of us, unfortunately, do not give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala half an hour of their daily time for the 5 days of prayer. Some of us are not willing to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala some money for His sake, for zakat, for salah. So the sacrifice, when we remember Ibrahim alayhi salam, we need to carry it beyond Qurban. And as we were keen on the Mi'ar of Qurban, we should be keen on other things. The salah, the 5 daily prayers, are very important elements in the life of the believers. We should never lose one of them. We should always be very attentive to the 5 daily prayers. We should be always keen to give something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the needy and the poor, not only in need, but in every day of the year. The needs of our brothers and sisters are not only on the day of need, but on the whole year. When we remember these sacrifices, we remember many of the sacrifices that we have made for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we do something similar or less, we always ask Allah for the rewards. So we always purify our hearts and make our niyyah purely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek the rewards from Him, and it will come to us sooner or later. Allah will reward us and we will get the best rewards for our deeds. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. We see, mashallah, people of every color, of every language, of every background, and the use of this religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said is that it belongs to every one of you. It belongs not only to Muslims, but to humanity. Any person who came on this earth and came to Islam is accepted. It belongs to it. As those who were born Muslims, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this guidelines for every human being on earth, and it will continue to be like this till the day of judgment. The unity of the Muslim Ummah, despite its diversity in language, in color, in background, is very important. And we must, as Muslims, work always towards bridges among each other, between us, and to link every Muslim into the fold of Islam, to bring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to bring the Muslim Ummah together, and to strengthen our Iman through these gatherings and similar gatherings. Finally, we feel the people of Muslims when we come together. There are people who are making great sacrifices for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remember our brothers in Syria who have been displaced from one place to another just because they sought the freedom. They sought to live free in their country. And they wanted this is their crime. And the punishment was that they were born. They were killed. They were made refugees in their homeland. And this is, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they ask for your prayer and your support that this calamity will soon go away and they will return to stability and they will return to happiness and peace, inshallah. We remember many wounds in the body of the Muslim community. Our brothers in Palestine, in Kashmir, in Somalia, in Burma, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring peace to all of them, to bring happiness and prosperity to all of them so they could enjoy the life. But with the prayers, we need to do something more. We need to help, and our help could be most importantly with financial help. They need our support for the orphans, for the wounded, for believe, they are in dire need of your help and support. Remember them in your prayers and remember them in your donation. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us all to the best grace in our lives. Allahumma ajma'na ala ma yurdika wa hawwilna wa bayna ma'asiyik. Allahumma ajma'na min al-mutahabbin. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma ansur al-islam wa al-muslimin. Allahumma man arada al-islam wa al-muslimin khayran wa wafiqhu li kulli khayr. Wa man arada al-islam wa al-muslimin sharran fakhudhu ila azizi wa hakim. Allahumma la tana'ani al-hajjuna illa wa fahda wa la hamni illa farashda wa la aynan illa satabda wa la daynan illa qadayta wa la mariqan illa shafaita wa la dhaliban illa radadta. Allahumma shfi maradana, Allahumma afi mubtalana, Allahumma arham mawtana, Allahumma ij'al al-jannata min al-jannah min al-jannah ya arhamar rahimin. اللهم إنا نعوذ برضاك من سخطك وبمعافاتك من عقوبتك وبك منك لا نصرف ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن ونعوذ بك من فتنة النار ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن فتنة المسيح الدجال. اللهم وإذا أردت فتنة في قوم فتوفنا غير مفتونين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالحق والإحسان والإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
Straighten your lines and fill the gaps.
الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك، فإن مع العسر يسرا، إن مع العسر يسرا، فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله الله أكبر. الله الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، وإلا